Did I make you an early morning convert?
Hmm? You know what? I think that there's a really big difference between getting up at dawn and staying up till dawn. But you know, you were right. It was magical, especially in the garden.
Especially with you.
It's funny. What, we've known each other a couple of months, and it seems like last night I got to know, well, just like I first met you.
I know, you know, I feel the same way. But the fact is last night I talked an awful lot more about me than we talked about you. Why don't you tell me a little bit about you and what it was like when you were growing up?
Oh, do I have to? I mean, yeah, I really don't have a lot of warm fuzzies, you know.
Really?
No.
There was no shaved ice and no root beer where you came from?
No, but there was actually a foster mom who made sugar cookies with sprinkles on top. I don't know, one of the days that a social worker came to visit. Come on, Sam, it wasn't all bad.
Really? Well,
no.
What was the good part?
Turning 18. Getting my independence. Finding my mother, getting her out of that hellhole that she was in. Mama's gonna love you. She is.
I hope so.
I think you'll like her too. She's, Addie, she's very perceptive in a very childlike way, but she, well, there's really only two different types of people in her world. They're good and bad, and I know she's gonna peg you for one of the good guys right away. What?
Did you know your eyes change color with the light? I mean, they just change.
They do?
Yeah, they change completely. I mean, I remember last night at the opera. I looked at you, and there was music going right through your eyes. It was.
Sam Rappaport. Yeah. You are the most romantic man ever.
I'm merely observant. Then at the opera last night. I mean, in the garden outside. The stars were shining, and I looked in your eyes, and I saw Catwoman. Your eyes became mysterious like a cat. They did.
Yeah.
And then the garden a little bit later there.
Well, they were,
much later.
Bloodshot. That's what they were.
Yeah, they were a little bit of that, but they were also peaceful. They were calm. They were serene. And they didn't have that guarded look you have an awful lot of the time, and I noticed. And I know now that it was necessary, you know. I know you have a reason for that guarded look.
Sam, you see more in me than anyone has ever seen.
Claire, just know that you never have to be afraid of me.
Hey. Coffee's ready. Why don't you have a cup and come jogging with me?
Are you nuts? I mean, I'm exhausted from a very pleasant but very active night. Aren't you?
No, I don't know. I'm not tired at all. In fact, it kind of gave me a boost.
Oh, you didn't need a boost. I can testify.
Because the idea of having this baby makes me think I can do just about anything.
I can testify to that, too.
Maybe we started our own little masterpiece last night, huh?
Yeah, honestly, with all the cooing and coddling and overprotecting that this kid's gonna get, it's not gonna stay a masterpiece for long, you know? I mean, do you really think that we're parenting material, you know, now that we know better, or should?
I think whatever we don't know, we're gonna learn on the job.
I mean, that's just so neurotic.
Yeah, tell me.
Thank you.
Look, our kid is gonna be fine, okay? He's gonna be very well adjusted.
Well, if he's well adjusted, then who will she play with? Because do we know any well adjusted people? Any at all?
Yeah. Hey, Vicky, come on in.
Thank you. Oh, hi, Nora. I'm awful sorry to bother you so early. My friend's out of town, and I'm supposed to go to China today.
China?
Oh, yeah, hot stuff. Appointed by the president.
Well, it's a journalistic symposium. At this point, I couldn't care less about it.
What's going on?
It's Jessie. She had some terrible falling out with Christian.
Oh, is she all right?
I have no idea. That's my problem. I don't know where she is. She told me she was spending the night at a girlfriend's house at Amy's, but she wasn't there, and she's not there now, and she's not with Christian. And I was really hoping that you could help me.
Hey, don't worry. We will find her.
Christian?
Hey.
Hey.
Oh, wait a minute.
What?
I know you. You're Lindsay Rappaport.
Buchanan. Also known as the Landview Pariah.
Oh, yeah? Is that a fact?
Well, I'm the one that had the gall to marry Vicky's ex, as well as being despised by yours. You are Hank Gannon, right?
Well, yeah, last time I checked. Now, has Landview really been that unfriendly?
Well, Vicky is somewhat of an icon here.
But she is a real decent lady.
Tell me the truth. Has Nora given you an earful about me?
No.
Really?
Wouldn't matter if she had. Look, your being married to Clint Buchanan is no business of mine.
Well, what a breath of fresh air.
You know what? The Buchanans, they're a pretty tight bunch. Just give them time.
You know, I think I'm just feeling a little displaced. My son Will just moved in with Sam, and he's going away to college, and I hate the sense that I'm losing him.
Yeah, I know about that.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm talking about Will. He's right down the street, and your daughter.
Yeah, right. She's in Statesville.
I'm sorry.
You know, Rachel and I, we used to run every morning here in the park, but now Bo is. He's keeping me company.
But not today?
No, I guess he's running a little late.
Oh, you're very quick.
Oh, yeah. But listen, he'll turn up.
He's a very good friend to you, isn't he?
The best.
Did you find out anything?
Good news. Guy on patrol spotted a car up at the lodge.
The lodge? Was it Jesse's?
Well, they took a peek in the window, and she appears to be just fine.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Then Annie asked me, she says, hey, when are you coming back as commish?
I'm so sorry. I didn't realize it would be awkward for you.
No, it wasn't awkward at all. Believe me, John Sykes is never even going to know I called.
They just really love him down there.
As well they should. Thank you.
Sure.
Now, I don't know what on earth Jessica's doing at the lodge all alone. I'm going to go there.
Well, Vicky, you know, Ashley, she's not exactly all alone.
That didn't happen. That couldn't happen, not like that. And us not remember?
Never meant for that to happen.
So did I. Not like that. Not with.
So it was your first time.
How could it be? How could that be?
Look, Jess, I mean, we're both pretty wasted, you know?
Sick of this. Sick of me, sick of meaning well and messing up all the time. Oh, look, I come to help you and it ends up like this. Jess, I'm sorry. I mean, it being your first time and everything.
I can't get it out.
And me, I was drinking to forget about a girl blowing me off who I hardly know. But you and Chris, that's 3 years, and I ruined that for you. And I'm sorry.
Oh, my God. Christian? What's gonna happen with Christian? My mom, oh my God, she's gonna kill me.
Don't. Look, nobody's gonna know about this, okay? I promise.
I'll know. Well, I'll always know. And how can I hide that from Christian? I mean, this was supposed to be ours, you know? He was so patient with me. I mean, 3 years. Your first time is supposed to be perfect. I thought we'd be engaged, even married. Is that old-fashioned or what?
No, it's not.
But it was supposed to be beautiful. You know, like my mom said it should be. Total commitment. Our bodies and our souls. Forever. In the morning, we'd wake up, we'd be together. In each other's arms. You did, didn't you? You used a condom, right?
Jesse, are you all right? What happened here?
Morning. Mr. Manning should be expecting me. Max Holden?
Mrs. Manning took him into his doctor's appointment, Mr. Holden. But he was expecting you and said you could wait.
But he did. I'm a little confused here. I thought only Mr. Rappaport or some worthy equal could take him out of this place.
Mr. Rappaport called at 6 this morning. And he said that he had arranged with the authorities for Mrs. Manning to take him.
Well, I guess Sam is on the job early, isn't he?
Can I get you anything, sir?
Oh, no. Not a thing.
Sam?
I'm digging out some papers for Todd's case. Give me a minute.
Okay. No problem.
Max Holden.
It's me.
Good morning. Thought I'd hear from you last night.
Look, Max.
Well, never mind. When do we celebrate your elevation to publisher?
Max, I need
to. Of course,
to
maybe we should write. Invite
Max,
Todd.
Listen,
Todd,
listen to me. Max.
Max. Yeah. There's been a change of plans, all right?
Really? How come?
Look, I can't really get into it right now. I can't explain it to you.
Hmm. Where are you?
I'm at the penthouse.
Why don't you come over?
I'll be there.
Hey, look at you. Those Will's clothes, you could start a new trend.
Yeah.
Looks good.
I need to head over to the Sun. A problem there.
Are you okay?
Sure. I'm just,
What?
I don't want to leave you, that's all.
Well, I know how you feel. I feel the same way. But we get to come back here tonight and pick up where we left off. Hmm? What is it? Something's wrong.
No.
What? Come on. I can see that look. I know that look of fear. It goes right across your face.
I'm just afraid I'm getting in too deep. How's that for honesty?
Well, if you're getting in too deep, you're not alone. I'm right there in that boat with you. Sink or swim.
Do you trust me, Sam?
Yeah.
Well, how can you? I mean, when you know so much about me.
Blair, maybe it's because I know so much about you.
I'd never hurt you. Not in a million years, I wouldn't. After last night and...
know. This morning.
It's okay. I'll feel the same way tonight. Promise. And we'll come back here after being at work all day. And it'll be just the same. Honest.
I hope so. Where are you off to today?
Well, I'm gonna go to the law library, and I'm gonna work on Todd's case, because if I can keep him from spending any time in jail, I'll be a very happy man.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna come back here, and I'm gonna spend time with you. Because if I can remove that look of fear from your face, my happiness will be complete.
Look at you, running in place while we're talking.
Yeah, I know it looks kind of silly, but I have to keep up that heartbeat.
Right. Okay, I'm gonna let you go. But don't you forget about the grand opening of my art gallery.
Oh, right. My brother told me that was happening.
Right, and I'm counting on you to be there, because, frankly, I'm having nightmares that no one's gonna show up.
Don't you worry. Once the word gets out, you'll have a full house.
You're very sweet.
Oh, well, I don't hear that very often. So listen, I'm gonna get on with it. I'll see you later, huh? Okay.
Could I just ask you something? How is
yeah, sure.
it that you have this fabulous 90s kind of relationship with your ex's current husband?
Well, I guess it's because I got to be friends with my ex-wife first.
That Nora. She's really something.
Yes, she is.
Tell me just one thing. What is it that she has that makes men go gaga? Because if they ever sell it in a store, I'm gonna buy it by the case.
Hey, there's the man.
Sorry I got hung up.
Yeah.
How you doing, Lindsay?
I'm good. I trust that you and Nora had a lovely reunion and very productive.
Yeah, I'll tell you one thing. I'm just glad to have her back. So are you ready for a couple of quick laps?
Let's rock. I'm ready.
You want to join us?
No, thanks. I have my own routine here.
All right. Let's go.
Bye, bye, guys.
Bye. I didn't hear you come in.
Concentrating on your work.
Yeah.
Having a little trouble keeping our head in our law case today, are we?
No, why would you say something like that, huh?
Because I recognize the expression on your face. It says I stayed up all night and I had a lot of fun doing it.
I have that expression on my face, do I?
Yes, it could almost be written on a T-shirt.
Yeah. Hey, let me have that. I know who that belongs to.
I just bet you do, counselor. Just bet you do.
Yeah.
Oh, that's with the scarf and the look. It's all adding up now.
Yeah, to what?
To whom? I think that's the most appropriate question. Why would you bring her here?
Why not?
Well, could it be a clue to her identity? Oh, no, ye gods, not another attorney. Were you here looking up reefs together, perhaps, as it were?
I wouldn't touch that line with a 10-foot pole. I like this. You know, you get to see me happy.
Yeah, it's nice. It's nice and amusing.
Amusing?
Seeing that half-sexy, half-sappy look on your face, it's definitely amusing.
You know, it's kind of funny, but I'd have to say you have exactly the same look on your face right
now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, we know who put that look on my face. We don't know who put the look on your face.
Lose something last night.
Where did... I must have. I dropped that somewhere.
Save the cover speech, would you? This plus this says you succumbed to the dubious charms of Mr. Goody Two Shoes last night. Just tell me one thing. Did you tell him the truth about Todd? Does he know that Todd's faking it?
Not yet.
Good. guess you haven't lost your mind completely. So we'll just proceed as planned. A little blackmail, and Todd will hand us...
No, Max, no.
No, no, no. What do you mean, no? I can't stop now. We're right in the middle of it, you see. Oh. I am flattered you actually believed I gave you the only copy. Just goes to show you what a bad influence on you Sam is.
You double-crossed me.
Sweetheart, we double-crossed each other, which once again proves that we are made for each other.
You lying, well, stinking
Hey, no reason to get nasty here. Who's looking out for both of our interests here? Me. I didn't do anything that we hadn't already planned, and it's going fabulously.
No, Max. I changed my mind.
A twinge of conscience?
No!
Forget it. Don't.
Not this time.
This time? Every time? All the time. Because you think like me.
Stop saying that, Max! Not anymore! Not anymore!
Oh, listen, if, you think this whole thing with Todd having up against the ropes is gonna mess up your thing with Sammy boy, get over it. No, Todd was very good, I gotta admit, but I was better. He heard that tape and he blinked, and he will be serving up the sun on a silver platter before the day is done. And don't tell me that doesn't make you happy, because I know you better.
You don't have a clue about what makes me happy.
Sure I do.
No, you don't.
I know what makes you happy. Not only that, I know what makes you tick. Although this threw me momentarily. I thought you had more guts. But hey, big night of dress up, some sappy music, a private seat in the box at the opera. What was it, Sam, reaching for your hand during a soaring duet? Man, sometimes I'm sorry I'm so damn amazing. But hey, all right, so you got snagged on a little loud music and high passion. Well, the fat lady has sung, the curtain has come down. Blair, it's a new day. It's a new start for you and me. I love you. I truly do. And please, don't do something like this to me again, because I don't think my heart could take it.
I'm sorry, Max.
He doesn't love you the way I do. He never will.
That's a chance I'll just have to take.
Why? Why?
Because
why?
I love him.
Oh, no, you
I
don't.
I do. Yes, I
you
do.
Don't you love him.
Yes,
I know
do.
You don't love him. You know what you love? You love the fantasy of you being somebody other than who you really are. I'm not a saint. I wish I was, but you know what? I've learned to live with it. And you better learn to live with it, too. Because you... and me, we are the same person. We are meant to be together. We will be together. I love you, and don't turn your back on that.
I love Sam.
Blair?
Yeah, come on, what are you so shocked for? You knew we were seeing each other.
Well, I knew you had a... She went away with Max Holden, and... frankly, I was relieved.
Yeah, you know why you were relieved? Because you have some misconceptions about Blair, and you're wrong.
Well, which, of course, they're only based on recorded history and known fact, including her marriage to Asa, her marriage to Todd.
Oh, stop. Now, you know what? When you look at Blair, I know that you see, what, an opportunistic wheeler-dealer, right?
Well, what do you see, Sam?
I see the wheeler-dealer also. But I see a woman that I see a beautiful, sexy, intelligent woman. I also sometimes see the little girl in her.
Oh, Sam.
What? Look, the fact is that she became a very strong-willed, iron-willed person to get what she wanted out of life, just in order to survive.
Okay. Just be careful, will you? Blair plays by a set of rules that you're not familiar with.
Oh, come on.
No. She's like a whole new, breed of heartbreakers. She's like a whole new species.
Wait a second here. Now, I have my PhD in a broken heart, okay? And you happen to be my graduate school. And what did not kill me made me a lot stronger. So, believe me, I can take care of myself here, right?
Okay. So I seen that joyful, sappy look on your face, who am I to argue?
Yeah. Okay.
If you're happy, I'm happy for you.
Well, good. Thank you.
What?
What is it? You've got a secret.
I don't
Come on,
see
yeah,
it.
I can tell.
It's not
Come
a
on,
secret.
Just spill
it's not
it.
Even
just,
news
just,
yet.
And what
well,
is it?
It's, hopefully it'll be news soon, but it's not, you know. And but it's, it's going to be the kind of news that's really going to rock Poe and Nora for the next couple of decades.
Decades? Are you going to start a family with Bo? Are you kidding?
Hey, wait a minute. What did you have for breakfast? You are pumped up.
I'm just thinking about my kid. You know, it's great having him around.
Yeah, he turned out all right.
No thanks to me.
No, look, I disagree. Drew only straightened himself out since you've been in his life.
Well, I'd like to think that I helped out a little bit, but you know, I missed out on all the early stuff with him. You know, first steps, first words, first ride on a bicycle. And you know something? You think that Drew would be bitter about that, but nope.
Yeah, he's a good kid for sure.
He's a good cop, too.
Not that you're being biased or anything, right?
Well, who, me?
Okay, all right. What did Drew do to get his pop all puffed up with pride? What's up?
Last night, he gave us his blessing, you know, on this, a little plan that, that Nora and I have.
Blessings?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Are you talking about what I think you're talking?
Having a baby.
Oh, man, you are in for a ride.
Nora's already got me practicing all my diapering skills, all that stuff. But I started thinking about this. And you know what? I'm going to get a chance to experience all the stuff that I missed out on before.
Well, my friend, see, what you've got is that old baby fever. No, really, you know, you grow a few inches taller, or at least you think you do. Yeah. And then you start to become really handy around the house. And you see other ladies on the street, and you start to tell them how cute their kids are. And then you imagine miles and miles of electric trains. But the worst, the absolute worst, is you get this dumb, stupid smile on your face that you just can't wipe off. Yeah, just like that one right there. That's the smile I'm talking about.
That's about it.
Right. Have you actually ever changed a diaper?
Nope.
Don't you worry, buddy. I'll walk you through it.
All right.
But listen, a word of caution. When Nora was pregnant, she drove me crazy. She had to have everything right here, right now, all the time. Made me nuts.
Well, I'll tell you something. The way I feel about Nora right now, whatever she wants, whatever, I'll go all the way to the end of the earth to bring it to her.
Look, Mrs. Carpenter, Jess and I... Well, she was pretty upset about Christian.
Thank you. Jesse, I want you to tell me what happened. Now, yesterday, you were at home and Christian was there.
Yeah, he wasn't there for too long.
Did you have another fight?
He told me I was a spoiled brat and I didn't know what it was like to struggle for anything.
Why would he say that?
So Will and I, we...
We saw Christian and Roseanne together again.
Yeah, but that's no excuse for what we did.
No, it isn't. It really is not. You lied to me again about being at Amy's?
I was here with Will.
Look, I might as well tell you right off. We were drinking here. But it's all my fault. I just was dragging Jess along with me. Please don't blame her.
Jessica, why would you do that?
Trust me, I'm the one to blame, really.
I'm sorry.
Jesse, drinking is not the answer. I thought you knew that. I mean, I can't even think of anything stupider than what you two did.
Me neither.
At least you weren't driving this time.
Yeah, my dad's pounded that into me really hard.
Did either one of you get any sleep?
Will slept in the guest room. I took Grandpa's.
You know what? I think you'd better excuse us. I really need to talk to Jesse alone.
Yes, ma'am. If Jess is okay.
I'm okay. Are you sober?
Yeah. Yes. Very.
There are an awful lot of things that I would like to say to you, but I will leave it to your father, because I fully expect you to tell him exactly what happened. And if you don't, I will.
Talk to you later.
My baby. I heard you worked alone here. I thought you were probably with Christian, and I was so afraid you might have done something that, well, that you weren't ready for, something you might regret.
I feel so sick. I feel awful.
That is the alcohol, and it will go away in time, although hopefully it'll teach you a lesson. As far as Christian's concerned, I'm so awfully sorry. You know what? I'm not going to go on this trip. I'm going to stay home with you.
Mom, you have to go. The symposium.
No. They'll survive without me.
Yeah, but Mom, the president.
So will he.
Mom, please go. I mean, you can't cancel your trip to China. I'll feel even worse.
Jesse,
Mom, please. I will survive.
Well, I know you'll survive. You're a very tough young cookie, but...
I can handle this. Let me handle this. I mean, if you missed your trip because I did something stupid, that's ridiculous. I'm so proud of you, being appointed by the president.
Do you realize how much more important you are to me than any of that stuff?
Yes, I do.
Do you really?
I do. I'm so proud of you, Mom. I'll even wave goodbye to your plane like when I was little, okay?
But you're not little anymore.
Oh, you're so grown up. Not last night, I wasn't.
But today you are. You made a mistake, you took responsibility for it, you owned up to it. It's a really grown-up thing to do. And then you're driving harder to make it right. Okay, I'll go. But I'm gonna miss you very, very much.
You did, didn't you? You used a condom, right?
Well, you don't have to be so astonished. I'm not that old.
No. But it had nothing to do with that at all. It was just that, you know, a couple of months ago, you and Beau were next to breaking up.
Well, what we went through made us even more solid.
Yeah, okay. You sure this isn't, you know, the marriage isn't working, let's have a baby kind of...
You giving me a hard time because I gave you a hard time about Blair?
No. Look, truth is, I really understand. I do.
I know it's insane, but it just feels so right, Sam. And I am flying.
Yeah, I can see that, and I'm very happy for you.
You tell Blair for me. But she is one lucky lady.
Well, thank you. I will.
So it's new beginnings for both of us.
Well, it's about time, don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If Todd's exposed and goes to prison, you know you don't stand a chance of getting your hands on the sun. You're spending the rest of your life trying to climb your way to the top.
I love Sam.
Don't forget about Sam. It's too late for Sam. You had your chance. If you'd been
you wouldn't
with
let me.
Oh,
Max.
Since when don't you do whatever the heck you want to do, huh? You made your choice, Blair.
No, that is not
you
true.
You made the right choice.
No, that is not true. I threw the tape away. You lied to me.
Look, I don't want to do this. I don't. But if I have to, for your own good, I'm going to walk over to Sammy, and I'm going to tell him that you knew that Todd was faking it from the very beginning. And then we'll see if St. Sam is all warm and fuzzy. What do you say?
How can you stand there and tell me that you love me?
Because I do. God help me, I do.
Oh, no, no. You don't know the meaning of a word. And neither did I. Until last night.
Listen, you can beg, you can plead, you can lash out at me. I'm never letting you go.